basically I would be dreaming at night and I couldn't fall asleep because I was thinking of all these different combinations. Usually if I've pictured it on my head, a lot of times it means that it's possible. Motivation to skate in the beginning, it was because of surfing. And what I found about skateboarding that I liked the most was its endless creation. Well, in the beginning I used to skate at least 8 hours a day. I always thought it was so fun, so I was skating street with my friends, but then I discovered all the Paul Peralta videos. I was mind blown because I couldn't believe that there was all these kinds of skateboarding. I found freestyle. I just thought it was so artistic, you know. I would skate freestyle at night, and then during the day I would skate street. I started trying to mix the two pretty much from the beginning. I like skateboarding as a whole. It's just a lot of fun. When they saw that I was doing freestyle, they were really supportive. And at the same time, in the beginning, I was doing gymnastics. And I remember I saw someone doing a handstand on a skateboard. A friend of mine told me, well, if there's someone that can do a handstand on a skateboard, it's gotta be you. You've been doing gymnastics, right? That makes sense. Maybe I just really need to practice mixing some of what I was doing before with what I'm doing now, skateboarding. What I enjoy the most with skating is just making really artistic videos where I can showcase tricks that I've never done before and that I feel like they have my own touch, even if they have influences from other skaters. My ultimate goal is to do something different. If I can do a little something that is just mine, then I really feel like it's an art. That's how I see skateboarding.
Tell me what you get out of it. There must be a lot of enjoyment of thinking one of these things up.
It's great for me to write down all these different ideas. If I don't write it down, I might never think of this trick ever again. And so before I'm gonna make a video, what I do is I have these 4 notebooks or so that I'll go through them, just reading and reading and reading, and thinking of all these different tricks. I'll think of this one trick, and then right after I'm reading this other trick, then I'm like, well, maybe I could mix both of them, and it just makes something different.
Give me an example of some of the early tricks or combinations that you invented when you started finding your voice.
Technically, it's all influenced by something someone has done before. I didn't invent the manual Duffy, but in one of the videos, skate escalation on a mani pad, I put a skateboard on top and I did ollie to Duffy, and I don't think that had been done before. Then what I tried in other videos is try to grab something I've done before and develop it more. In the next video, what I did was heel flip to Duffy on a mani pad, then heel flip to nose Duffy with both feet on the nose. The next video, heel flip to nose Duffy, shove it to regular Duffy. The Searching Sirocco, that's when I do a heel flip Duffy to backwards Duffy. It was just a combination of everything. So just try to have fun skating, and that's the main thing. So the first video that I made with Brett Novak, that got about 300,000 views very quickly. But the first one I did mixing street and freestyle, it got about 1 million views in a month or less. That was crazy. We couldn't believe how much attention that video got. There was like a little fan base that was created just from that video, and they were asking us to make another video. When I made the third video, Skate Regeneration, we filmed it in Barcelona. That video we were actually really trying, and that video had a lot more success. Less than a month, it had 2 million views.
So Killian, what's the most views that you've had on a YouTube posting?
Skate Regeneration today has almost 5 million views. But then what happened, for example, with Alter Route, that video got 3 million hits on Vimeo and then about 2 million hits on YouTube, but then it was played on different TV channels. And that's what happened with some of those videos. So it's really hard to tell how many millions of people have watched some of these videos. I remember at that time Kevin Harris wanted to talk to me, and I couldn't believe it because he was a skater that I definitely looked up to, and now he's calling me, telling me that he wants to talk to me. And I was like, what? So he told me that he saw potential in me and that he was gonna try to get me on the Paul Peralta team. Just hearing those words to me was incredible because it was a dream come true. Give it time. Turn the bass up. When I'm making videos, I'm really just trying to express myself, and if people like it, great. If they don't like it, I love it. So that's what I'm gonna do, and it's so much fun. That's, for me, why it's an art. My goal when it comes to supporting myself skateboarding is to at least do one commercial a year, because my wife and I live very simply. I've never really tried to be rich with it or anything, just enough to get by, and that's what I'm happy with. Gratitude and being content is a recipe for happiness. Work that my wife and I do, it's actually the first thing in my life, and we've been to the Myanmar country about 3 times. So we've gone through the effort of learning their language and knowing how to read their language just because of love for these people. What we do is that we help the refugees that come here. We teach them a little bit of English and
that's important to you, to give back?
It really adds meaning to life. I'm not just living for myself, I'm living for others and trying to help them.
What's next in skateboarding for you?
We're hoping to make a new video in Myanmar.
Do they have skateboarding in Myanmar?
Yes, actually they have a couple of skate parks, but I don't think they're really used to seeing skateboarders. There's a lot of potential in that country because a lot of kids, they just want to try it. I have written down a lot of tricks that I want to do, so I think it'll be really fun to go again and make a skate video there.
Killian, that's wonderful. That's really wonderful.